buzzing on that beat.
Addicted to balling, I have to get my cash. The money is calling, got bands, got bands, got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I have to get my ends. I pull up in my Benz, flexing, counting my bands. Started getting money, I see how it feels to be rich. I live by the beach now, that's how I should live. Since I was a toddler, I knew that I would become this. I cannot move slow, that's a big, big no. Gotta chase this money, bankroll after big bankroll. I must get this money, I must get this money. I must get this money, get this money, get this money.
First opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Minnesota Vikings and the Chicago Bears. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Gun. They'll look to throw. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Give him 11 yards that time on the return, and the Bears take over. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. And he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Now Trubisky to throw on second. He's going to rifle one deep left side. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and ten. Now it's Trubisky. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Cohen. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Wide open receiver complete. And down he'll go at the 25. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
And the third down pass falls incomplete.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
Yeah, first quarter only, but they're 0-for-2 on third down conversions to start this thing. And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five.
Lucky 56, Detroit.
They're going to try and throw. Hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game, and that will force a turnover on downs. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would...
And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
Well, that was a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
Yeah, pounced right back on it, keeps possession. Well, the first play of the drive lost 4. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he stopped immediately there. It's Xavier Rhodes there in on the stop. He makes a wonderful play there off the corner, protecting his side of the field.
Oh, that reminds me of the great defenses of old, doesn't it? The Pittsburgh Steelers, Steel Curtain, they would not let you get on the field if you could only do one thing. You had to be a complete guy, and you had to be able to tackle.
Now, I know I've said this, now Trubisky lost the football. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. So as they take it over, we step aside. So look at this. Here's the field goal unit coming out. And he is going to need to bomb this one. This will approach NFL record territory. It's a 62-yard attempt. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. And Charles, when you start talking about NFL kickers that have hit from 62 or further, it's a pretty short list, isn't it?
That it is. But how about the trust by a head coach to even let your kicker try from that range? That's really showing a lot of faith that he can get the job done.
Yeah, faith and guts. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Second and six, just inside the 30. On play action, they'll throw. Going deep for Diggs. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Vikings! Stephon Diggs with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead. And there, Charles, he lined up out left, ran the post, caught it over the middle, and the rest, as they say, is history.
And you have to love the scheme that they just showed there, because if you're going to run a deep post, you ordinarily have to get a safety out of the middle of the field. And you do it one of two ways. Either by running routes at him that carries him away from it, or you either freeze him in the middle with routes that run underneath so that he doesn't get depth. Then you throw it over the top, and boy, what a successful play that was.
Well, not content with a first quarter lead, I guess. They're going to go onside kick. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game. And maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They got to steal it and try and gain an advantage. And they tried. They just didn't get it done.
It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11. Brandon Gauden, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number two. But they face a second and long to start things out. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. All right. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he